It's not every day that I get to show you a new Lincoln, but today is one of those days. This is the new 2024 Lincoln Nautilus. Now, Nautilus is not a new nameplate for Lincoln, but they are saying that this is an all-new vehicle, new platform. It's 2 inches longer, 2 inches wider, a little bit taller as well. It's got new powertrains. It's got a radical new interior that I think you're going to find really interesting. So what is so new about the new 24 Lincoln Nautilus? Well, let me take you through it. The styling of the new 24 Nautilus is obviously considerably different than the outgoing 23 model, and that shows up most here in the front end. Now, if you're familiar with Chinese market Lincolns, this is not going to be new to you because this basically looks like the Chinese market Lincoln Zephyr four-door sedan, but over here, this is the first time that we're seeing it. It's what Lincoln is calling Quiet Flight 2.0 design language, and it really does look good. You've got that light-up Lincoln star right in the middle that then moves out into the LEDs along the headlights, which creates a really cool welcoming animation. Down the side of the vehicle, you have a lot more sculpture than you did before. They've got the scallop in the doors, which really does look fantastic. This vehicle has 22-inch wheels. This is the jet package, so you've got kind of a blacked-out two-tone trim as well. Looks really good. When it comes to powertrains, you've got a choice of two for the new 24 Nautilus. The base model uses a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder making 250 horsepower, or you've got an optional hybrid version that still uses that same 2-liter turbo, but also adds an electric motor and a continuously variable transmission, and it makes a system 310 horsepower. All-wheel drive will be standard across the board on all trim levels as well. But the bigger changes to the Nautilus are actually inside, where you've got a new interior and a new display panel that I think is going to knock your socks off. You remember when Lincoln first came out with their digital gauge clusters and they were all proud of it, that it was reconfigurable and looked all classy and whatnot, but the rest of us were kind of like, it's a little bit boring. It's mostly black with a couple of numerals in it, not all that exciting. Well, look at Lincoln now. They have decided to go all out with a digital gauge cluster, and now you have 48 inches of coast-to-coast display. Not exactly 48 inches. You have two 23.6 inch screens, one over here, one over there, which, no, doesn't quite total 48 inches. It's Ford math, but like how the 5-liter V8 really wasn't 5-liter. Anyway, this looks fantastic. It is bright, it is bold, it is easy to use. In front of you directly, you have the speedometer, tachometer, and the navigation system, which is now a Google-based system, so it's running Google Maps. On the right side panel, you have three distinct panels that you can configure in a number of different ways to show all kinds of different information. What it will not show you, however, is streaming video while you're driving. When you come to a stop, when you put it in park, then the new Nautilus can act as what they call a rejuvenation center. It's got programs in it that will combine everything from lights and sound and music and fragrances as well. There are three different fragrances that actually come with the vehicle to create a kind of relaxation spa. The seat will even massage you depending on what trim level you get as well. So if you do use your car as an escape, well, this isn't an escape, it's a Nautilus. But still, it will act as a spot. More about the display. It is all controlled from this 11.1 inch touchscreen that will allow you to adjust pretty much everything you see up here. All you do is just push a couple buttons, and you're able to reconfigure and rearrange panels as you like them, or if you want, beep, shut it off entirely so that all you have is the speedometer in front of you. Probably more useful for driving at night so you don't have all that kind of distraction. But frankly, I would leave it on because you've got all kinds of really cool content and you've got a number of different themes as well that you can switch between to get a different kind of atmosphere. What is more interesting, however, is this. The steering wheel is a squircle, as we call it. It is rectangular and you're looking at your speedometer and all the information above the steering wheel. What this does is it eliminates the need for a heads-up display. So you're not seeing anything displayed above the hood, but the hood and the dash is actually a little bit higher than normal, and you're looking at things pretty much just off the road. Not bad, don't hate it. I think it's definitely gonna be something that a lot of people remark on when they get into the new Nautilus. The new 24 Lincoln Nautilus is bigger, it's bolder, it's more comfortable, it's got a lot of great technology, and you can go and order a new 24 Nautilus at Lincoln.com. All the pricing is also up on the website as well. Deliveries are going to start in early 2024. If you'd like to learn more about the new 2024 Lincoln Nautilus, you can look everything up on Cars.com. And if you like what you see here, be sure to click like, subscribe, and turn on notifications to get all of the latest videos from Cars.com and all the new products that are coming out.